Hey guys, and welcome to another video. So today we're continuing our Intercom Villa series, and it's actually the first part of the actual setups we'll be doing now. So as you see in front of us, we have a PoE switch, a door station, and a screen. So this is pretty much the most basic setup you can get, and I'm going to show you guys how to get this all connected and working. And we're going to run through some basic features like setting the time correctly and how to set the audio levels and things like that, just some basic stuff. Okay, so it's quite a good video to watch. And right now I'm just going to quickly test it, see what happens.
Calling failed.
The last things any Intercom installer wants to hear, okay? And the screen is on because it's been activated, ready to go. All that was done in part two. So I'm going to see you now again on IVMS. Catch you in a sec. All right, so we're over to IVMS. Our two devices ready to go. If you don't know how to get this far, guys, check out part two. I'll leave a link below. But let's go ahead and log into the door station and start setting it up. Okay, so obviously you click on the clog icon and you can log into the device. All right, so first things first is we're going to set the time. All right, guys, so this is the way we set the time. We're going to be using NTP. So this will get the time from the internet. Now, obviously, if you're doing an offline system, you're going to have to set this manually, okay? But we're going to be using the internet time here, and I'm going to set an interval of 1 minute. This is just for a test, guys, just to show you how it works. Okay, so we've set our time here, we've got the time zone, that's perfect, ready to go. Now we're going to go to enable daylight savings time. Okay, this is something you should always do, okay, especially if you've enabled NTP. So it's the last Sunday in March at 1 o'clock and the last Sunday in October 2 o'clock, bias 60 minutes. Click on save. Okay, now once we give it a minute, it's going to update the time and it's going to give us the correct time, okay? But we'll come back to that now in a minute after we've added our screen. Okay, so we go to device management where we can add the screen. So we're going to go add, and it's indoor station. That is a screen, okay? That's what they call it. So we're going to use our password. Okay, we've got the serial number over here, which is handy. This is why I do this, and the IP address as well. Okay, so this is 255. This is always the same, guys. Okay, I should copy this as well. Okay, and the default gateway is always the IP address, which is the one. And this is going to be screen number one, floor number one. Okay. All right, so that's been added. As you see here right now, it should say offline. Make this bigger, offline. Okay, but that will change in a minute. So now we're going to go over to our screen. We're going to click on here. Okay, and like before, we're going to go to the time settings. Okay, so NTP is already enabled. You see the synchronization interval is already 1 minute. What does that mean? It means it's taken our information from our door station automatically, because they will never set this for a minute. Okay, so now just don't basically set it. All you have to do is set the DST exactly the same as you did for the door station, and then don't click on anything else, just click on save, and that's it. The time is now going to be synced completely and it's going to be linked to the internet, so it should always be perfect. Okay, guys, obviously if they change daylight savings time, then everyone's gonna have a problem, but that's the story for another day. All right, so I'm gonna leave it on 1 minute just for the sake of it, but I will change it later. But yeah, as you see, guys, it does work, and when we go to the live view, you'll see it works perfectly. But now let's go back to our setup. So we go to network and group network settings, the last one right at the bottom, guys. And as you see here, main door station IP. It's already found the door station IP. They're already communicating, okay? This is what we want. So we just have to put in the password. Okay, click on save. Now, I'm gonna go over, I would usually go over to the main live view and show you how it works, but I'm just gonna show you now. It should say online. Okay, so you know when it says online here on the device management that everything has worked lovely. Okay, online now. Okay, let's go, it's the live view. I'll be back on here in a minute, but let's go make sure it works. Catch you in a sec. All right, guys, so we're over to our live view now. And as you see, the time is 10:22. I'm checking the clock now on the wall. It's exactly 10:22. So that is the time all set up. And then the door station should have the same time, but we're gonna go check out a few more door station features in a minute, and we'll make sure that time is good as well. All right, but now we're gonna do a quick test. No problems there, guys. All right, that's easy as it gets. We're doing an Intercom setup. All right, didn't take long. Very straightforward. So back to IVMS right now. All right, guys, back on IVMS now. Let's log on to the door station and let me show you a few things we're gonna we can change and look at. Okay. So obviously your basic information is not much here. You've got the time settings, which we already looked at. Maintenance. Obviously you can update the firmware from here, default the unit. If you are using a used unit before, secondhand one, make sure you unlink it from any Hik-Connect accounts. Okay, user management, and these things we'll be getting to later. Same with network. Network is basically getting you online, guys, through platform access. But I'm gonna do a whole video on that later. Okay, but where it gets a bit more interesting is video and audio. So you see here, by default, it's actually set the resolution to 720p. I don't know why it does that. So let's go make sure it's 1080p. And I'm going to have a nice highest video quality. Why not? All right. So now we've sorted out our mainstream, substream. That should be fine. And now look at our audio options. Okay. So audio options, guys. So you got the input volume. So this means when people are talking outside, how loud is it going to be when you're listening to it on the screen? So this I like to set to 10. Okay. The output volume is basically how loud the doorbell rings. When it, for example, when you're ringing, it will start ringing. And when you try to use a key fob or something like that, it's going to go, the door is open. Some people really don't like this. So you can set this to 0. But when you still, obviously you still have the two-way audio, so you won't have any sound. Essentially that volume outputs sound effects, things like that, but I like to set the speak volume up here. I like my output volume a bit lower, and that should do it, because guys, you can always reduce the audio on the screen as well, so why not have the input volume on 10? That's the way I see it. Okay, so we've set up that. Now we're gonna check out the image. Okay, so you can obviously change this here. You might want to increase the brightness. That's quite a common one to do. Settings up here. WDR is good if you're in like a low light or an area where it's got mixed light settings. It's not too bad. And but most of these things, like day-night switch, that means it's going to be automatically clicking to night vision mode when you go. So there's not many of these things you will need to touch. All right, guys. And the on-screen display. This is for the time and things like that. That's because it's display the name. Let's give it a name. Okay, camera name. We're going to give it a door station. All right. And we like day, month, year. Okay. So now, is there a way we can see the time? Yeah, 10:38 there, guys. So it says the same as the screen. That's how we want it. And you can move these around and save it. Okay. In mind. All right. Okay, we're not going to be using cropping, guys. Events. This is for motion detection. To be honest, guys, I wouldn't get too excited about motion detection here. It's your old school motion detection. It's going to keep triggering all the time. So unless you've got like a very unique situation where not many people are going by, and you want to know when people go by, then I really wouldn't recommend using the motion detection. Okay. And event linkage is basically when you detect the motion, it's going to give you a notification to your app. All right. Schedule. I'm not too sure. I guess this is to do with when you're using the key fobs and things like that. Obviously, if you're running an office, you can set the times. But I'm afraid that you're going to have to look into that yourself, guys. Now we've got the intercom. Now, these are settings we don't really need to touch right now. As you see, it's... They give the villa station door station number 0. I don't know why, but it is number 0. Okay, we don't have to do this. You can put your password in here. It's not going to do any harm, especially if you do more complicated setups. Okay, so yeah, this is your ring call duration. Okay, you can change that, but I don't see any problems with the settings there. Ring back tone is when you're ringing the door station, it goes bring, 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 bring. You can change that, but you're going to have to make sure the format is correct. I've never heard anyone needs to change that. Press button to call. So this is obviously your press button is going to call the screen. There's no settings there, and there's nothing we need to do that. Okay, access control. So this is when we're going to be adding locks later, so we will be looking at this later. device management, again guys, this is back to our door station. We use this before and users. So when we add a user later, this is where we're going to come and add a user. All right guys, so that's a pretty good rundown of the door station basic guide. And now let's get to some more complicated setups in the next video. So stay tuned, and probably have a link coming up right now. So please click on it if you want to see the next video. Thanks for watching, and see you again. Bye bye.